All right, last episode, we returned to Crookback Bog with both the Baron and his daughter, coincidentally, who just happened to be there when we got there. And unfortunately, that's Anna, his wife, her mother. And that one body's bouncing up and down. That's weird. Anyway, Anna's now another water hag, so we're going to go try to find Johnny, our lovable little friend, and see if he can fill us in on the situation. And hopefully he's not mute again or been murdered in some way. Hello, Drowner. You're a little underleveled fighting me, aren't you? I say as I take hits right in the face. Oh, crap. Level plays way less of a role in combat than you'd expect it to sometimes. It's like, nope, that's still me taking oh, whoa. Ah, well, there's the hole in that strategy for health recovery. It's like, oh yeah, you recovered some health with that shield. And then they kept hitting you. And that didn't work out. Are they coming after me again, or do I just keep going towards the goal? I'm just gonna keep going, I guess. Just pop a swallow. That was a little rough. Oh! This area has enemies of its own, and oh! Johnny's under attack. That's not good. Give me some hit points. You just stunned your teammate. That's a weird move. I don't know if I would really recommend that strategy for future use. Let's do Igni for fire damage. Fire damage against the water hag. Certain Pokemon rules make me think that's probably a bad idea, but it seems largely effective. Ow, dick. Trying to mute me. No, I can't. Does that stuffing on my screen make me not be able to cast? I was mashing R2 to try to cast my fire spell and nothing was happening. Weird. It just kind of happens sometimes, I guess. There we go. Got a nice adrenaline point. I need to get that point. I want to get that skill once I level up a bit, where there's a really cool skill that will make me get bonus damage from adrenaline points for both signs and combat. Right now it only affects combat, I think. Making my signs more powerful with the more adrenaline points I get would be very handy. More corpse loot. All right, Johnny, where are you at?
Johnny. Johnny!
Not here. Something's not right. Gotta look around. Might be hiding nearby.
I'm sure he's fine. This is a game where everyone comes out alright in the end, right? No one's ever had anything bad happen to them. Alright, well, we have clear tracks. Just go ahead and follow these. There we go. Yep. Trying to get closer. Alrighty. Johnny, where you at, boy? Is that you over there? Nope, you're going this way, apparently. Nope, what? Losing track of the tracks a little bit. Oh, supposed to interact.
Fresh footprints. Johnny ran through here, fleeing something.
I mean, I could have told you that. I'm not even a witcher. Is there anything special here? Is that Johnny?
Johnny, wake up.
What? Who? Witcher! You frightened me. Thought it were those vile hags.
Killed a few near your den.
The crone sent them to punish me.
Get on the crone's bad side?
I told him off. They don't like it when you tell them off.
Why'd you do it?
Wanted to help Gran. She's always been good to the children. What would have been the doldrums out here without him? She'd have died of boredom. Begged the crones not to hurt Gran, but they were angry she'd let the children escape.
So you saw what happened to Gran?
By happenstance, Gran mixed some poppy seed and ash. Went by to help her sort it out. Mother Nature gave me small hands, see? So I can do it easy-like. Working away we was, separating seeds from dust. Out of nowhere, Gran cried out. The mark on her hand started glowing. She yelled at me to hide. I crawled into a chest. Barely had time to blink before the crones tottered in. The weaver snipped a lock of Gran's hair. Called it punishment for letting the children escape. Then the hags opened the door in the floor. Went down, down, down. Shame it weren't all the way to hell.
take a look under the door?
I look like a fool to you?
No. You do look like the inquisitive type, though.
My inquisitiveness ends where folly begins.
Why'd the Weavest need Gran's hair? Any idea?
The crones take folks' ears to hear all. Hair gives them power over folks' lives. There are times they weave the hair into odd strings. Other times they take it downstairs.
Stay in the chest until the crones left?
Wanted to. Sit tight and quiet, said to myself. Not peep out your beak till they go. But then Gran fell to the floor. Started screaming and tearing her hair out. Didn't know what to do. So I leapt out of the chest. Thought herbs might help her. The ones she cured the children's aches with. But Gran was no longer herself. She was a beast.
So, you give her the herbs?
Couldn't manage it. The crones came back. I dropped to my knees and begged them to spare Gran. Brewess piped up first. Naughty boy. Oh, naughty. Shouldn't say no when the sisters want to hear yes. Then the Wispeth says, run, boy, run before your legs rot off. They all laughed, and I legged it.
You escaped. Consider yourself lucky.
I do, but I've not lost the ladies for long. If I'm to live, I must hide, and I can forget my cozy hole. It's the first place they'll look if they set out to nab me.
Try deeper in the swamp, maybe?
I suppose I must. And what will you do?
There's something in that cellar. The key to finding out what happened to Gran, I think.
Will you help her?
Provided it's not too late. Thanks, Johnny. And good luck to you.
Likewise. And if you happen on any water hags, give them a nice fat walloping on me behalf. Farewell, Witcher.
All right, so what happened was real... I don't know if we learned that much new. I guess we learned that they took her hair, went somewhere underground, and then used that hair to transform her. So I guess what we learned is that if we go underneath that door, we'll find out what happened. I'm just hoping these guys stop chasing me. If I stop the fight every time an enemy shows up in the bog, we'll take an eternity, and they'll always get hits in, I think. Alright, let's try to see if we can fix Anna. Gran? As they say, or as he says, really, no one else.
Did you learn anything?
Just as I thought. The crones probably cursed your mother, took a lock of her hair, then disappeared down the stairs. Cellar under the house. Cellar door is hidden.
In that case, we've no time to lose. Come.
Work alone.
This matter concerns us all.
We don't know what's in there. Your men will make a lot of noise, more than I'll make alone.
I am the Church of Eternal Fire's agent in these lands. It is my duty to go with you.
Fine. Just you, then. The rest stay here with Anna. Let me go in first. Give you a shout if I find anything interesting.
So be it. Let's begin.
All right, sparing some lives perhaps, but I still have some backup if when things go south, which they totally will, because that's what this game is. Let's take a peek-see, huh? All right, where's this door? Also, looting everything, because fuck these ladies. They don't deserve to have belongings. They're all mine now. Over here. Thank you. Not even sure what the uses of some of these things are, but they're all mine. Those plants. Prin grape. Hand fiber. Those were different plants. They look like the same plant to me. White gull manuscript page. Lesser Griff of Ard. Ooh, silver ingot meteorite. Timber. A number of useful things around here. Brynomia. Meteorite ingot. Brynonia. Moliero. Nothing else around here to grab? So just, it's so pleasing to just grab all the things that they hold dear. They probably don't hold the stuff dear. Can I get over there? There we go. A little bit of puffball. That'll probably be useful for my puffball bomb.
Got it.
Don't worry, I'm sure it's safe down here. More things! No, don't climb the ladder. That's not what I'm here for. Oh, pile of bodies.
By the eternal fire. I've never seen so many before.
Looks unsavory. What is all this?
The trappings of a black magic ritual. Witches weave human hair through dolls they first curse. They gain a grasp on individual souls this way.
Think one of the dolls represents Anna? Can we free her if we find it?
It's the only way I know of. But there are risks involved. The items woven into the dolls, see them? They symbolize the individuals the dolls are meant to represent. We must find the doll that is Anna and take it from here.
Seem to know a lot about this.
From tomes on black magic. Initially, we burned any that we found. Recently, we decided it might be wise to read them first.
Poisoning your minds with magic? Superstition? What's the Hierarch think of that?
Have you met the man?
No.
Neither have I.
This risk you mentioned. Take it we only get one shot at choosing the right doll.
I'll not chance it. I did not know Anna. You've learned much of her. Should find it easier to choose.
All right. Let's take a look at these dolls.
Doll with a red bead, doll with bird feathers, doll with a hollyhock bloom, doll with a human ear. Ah. Am I just looking at them? I'm just looking at them, right? What do I know about this woman, Anna? Hollyhock. Didn't she have hollyhock planted back at town? Red beard. I'm just looking at them, right?
This is interesting.
A doll with a flower. What's so interesting in that?
Not just any flower. A violet hollyhock. Baron once told me it was Anna's favorite flower.
You believe this to be the doll?
Might very well be, but I can't be sure. Should look at the others. Red bead attached to this one. Anna wears a string of those around her neck.
As do half the women from Novigrad to Vengerberg. This cannot be the one.
All right. I'll look at the others. Bird feathers woven into this one. If I had to bet on it, I'd say this doll represented Philippa.
Philippa Eilhart, if that's true, then...
Relax. First name that came to mind, that's all. Philippa's way too clever for the crones to have snared her in some trap. Besides, we're not here for Philippa. We're here to save Anna. And I can't think of any link between her and bird feathers.
That might seem obvious. But what if it's a ruse, and this doll, in fact, symbolizes Anna?
Doubtful. Crones would have no reason to employ trickery here. Should look at the others. Human ear attached to this one.
Belonged to one of the peasants, doubtless. Anna still has both her ears.
Let's look at the others.
Well, the human ear might have come from, like, I had to gather a human ear when I did the quest in the first place. So that one's almost promising of, like, well, no, he did say it has to symbolize them, though, right? It can't just be, like, I'm pretty sure I know where the ear came from, because I'm pretty sure I brought the human ear from that one peasant that cut it off, but that doesn't mean that it symbolizes him. Could it be the bloom? It's either the bloom or the red bead, then, as far as I can tell. I can't leave this menu, can I? Nope, I have to pick one. I can't exit out and go ask people about these features, apparently. So, he says everyone has red beads. Meanwhile, supposedly this is her favorite flower, so maybe that's hers, then?
A doll with it.
Not just any...
Maybe this is me. Maybe they're rewarding me here for spending extensive time talking to the Baron.
I'm sure it is. Taking it.
Quick, outside!
A werewolf. Oh, I don't get to loot the room anymore? Aww.
Mom, you're back. All will be well. You're going to be fine.
Her clothes are back?
I'm
dying.
She's not well. Raving. Doesn't rightly know what's happening. You're weak yet. You must rest.
No. Listen to me. The crones. I was to be their beast to the end, forever. You broke their spell. But now I must go.
Well, what's she talking about, Witcher?
The crones deceived us. Their curse is a death sentence. No way to lift it, at least not in a way that would let Anna live. We broke their spell temporarily, partly. Now it's gotta run its course.
What? What does that mean?
She's dying.
It's good to see you together.
I'm sorry, Annie. For everything. I'm sorry.
Mother.
Tammy. Do you remember that day on the Inner?
Of course. Those plums are so sweet. In your dress so blue. You wove me a wreath of flowers. We laughed the day away.
Please, remember me like that.
No!
I thank you. They had a chance to say goodbye. It was your doing.
Shame I couldn't do more.
Come, child. The eternal fire will soothe your pain.
Leave me be. Your pay will await you at Crow Perch. Collect it there.
None of this was your doing.
Well,
I know. Which makes it no easier to bear.
Pain will pass in time.
I'd like to believe that. I would.
You may have a moment with her. Then we must bury her and return to Novigrad.
Very well.
That's unfortunate.
Leave me alone!
Oh.
Let's give her a moment. Let her gather her wits. Once she has calmed, return to Novigrad.
Yes, sir.
We'll deal with the witches.
Not enough of this,
don't you worry. Witcher.
I guess that's all they want to say to me. All right. Well. We'll have to go to Novigrad soon enough to follow up on some of this. Oh, I can't go back in. No. There's a key. Wait, that's the wrong door, isn't it? It's one of these. I wanted to finish looting that basement in case there was something else cool in there. So we unfortunately had a less than stellar ending for that character. She's quite dead at this point. But at least I broke the curse. And all of her clothes magically rematerialized after I did that. That was interesting. I didn't know that was how curses worked, and I totally guessed correctly, so she didn't die in a horrible pile of gore, or turn into a full monster and attack anyone, or whatever was going to happen if I messed up. Assuming I did it right, I think. Always hard to tell. Lots of alchemy paste, objects like that. Figured it'd be worthwhile to keep investigating. Alright, we're done with their creepy little ritual area. Oh, I'm overburdened. Oh, well, we'll have to resolve that in a moment. Probably sell a bunch of these items I'm picking up since I've picked up so much stuff from all the dead soldiers and things like that in the area. Here's my next thing I want to go into, though. I want to get new equipment, and there's something cool here. Bam! Griffin school gear. There's three levels of gear in this game. I think it's cat, griffin, and bear, but it could be something else. Anyway, Griffin is the medium armor set for witchers. And the way this game works is you have to get, like, the starter set, and then you continually upgrade it over the course of the game, much like the way that potions and oils are handled. And the first Griffin School gear quest is level 11, so I'm about ready to start this, and I might as well look into getting a new set, especially since it'll be a whole set that's well crafted for casters, hopefully. So scavenger hunt, Griffin, school gear. Geralt came across evidence of legendary witcher George's equally legendary equipment. Having heard many tales of this gear's extraordinary traits, Geralt decided to investigate, so he defined his grave. The way I found this in the first place, is I went over to the... I was in this menu. There's all these maps that I was picking up. They're not over here anymore. There's maps that are over here now. There's maps I was picking up from stores over the way that are people's different pieces of maps. First, second, and third. I'll go ahead and read through these real quick. So, Aldebert Cameron's first map. So when you read these the first time, they get added to your quest list. I haven't actually read these, but I clicked on them so that they would trigger on my quest at least. While conducting studies under the guidance of Professor Slavko Atimstein, I happened across four places where carved engravings portraying the sign of the cat school of witchers could be found. All of these pictograms are identical to that which we discovered in the caverns beneath the Temple Isle of Novigrad. I have marked them on this map. Adalbert Kemrith, adjunct in natural history at the Oxford Academy. So I have three of this map set, I think, and two of the other ones. So I might have to find more. I might have to find six pieces of map to get all 600 pieces. I'm not sure. Witcher pieces. There are more locations marked with the cat's head pictogram than we had suspected. Yet each remains identical to the one we have found in caverns under Temple Isle in Novigrad. I have marked these locations on the map. As per Professor Adamstein's instructions, I will not be conducting further explorations of the sites where I discovered pictograms relating to the cat school of witchers. These pictograms are identical to the ones the professor found in the caverns under Temple Isle. Then the other set I have is the Edwin Grefloff's first map. After being recruited by Professor Slavko Adamstein, to join his research group, I began to study the Griffin School of Witchers. My base of operations was the tomb under the Crookback Hills. The professor claimed this was the final resting place of one of the Griffins and wished to find a way inside. I quickly discovered a range of places of interest, each marked with a pictogram in the shape of the Griffin School Witcher medallion. I have marked these points on the map. So hopefully by the time we finish this little quest, I'll have a nice new set of Witcher gear to look at. Plowing syphilic son of a poxy whore, I lost the first map I prepared for Professor Adamstein in a game of Gwent. I must now return to the base camp near the tomb under Crookback Hills and start anew. Oops. Meanwhile, I will mark further points of interest on this map. Oh, you guys are really bad at this whole mapping thing. Alright, so let's figure out a goal. So, we have a marking right here, just north. Okay, worthwhile. I'm going to take a trip down to Downwarren, because I should... Tell me there's a vendor there. There's not a vendor there, is there? That's a bummer. I'm going to go visit a vendor somewhere, and then I'll see you guys in Downwarren, where we'll head through to find out whatever's over here, and then also proceed to look into this Witcher gear. Okay, so I may have jumped the gun in talking about Griffin School stuff right away. We'll start on that this episode. But obviously I should talk to Baron about following up on what we've had, and also talk to these vendors over here about getting rid of some of this extraneous equipment.
Help me, Ayas!
You may assist me by buying all this shit off of me.
Wouldn't.
I'm not in a hurry to craft anything, since obviously we're gonna have some really viable stuff to craft soon anyway. Yeah, all of the stuff is noticeably weaker and worth about 10 crowns each, so I'm happy to part with it and chip away at his quite extensive supply. Let's see, that's my weaker crossbow. It's just a regular old mace. I don't care about that at all. Let's go ahead and refilter. There we go. Just a hatchet. Yeah, these are all basic equipment. Ah, that's my relatively valuable gabeson. Arcanian Cures. I know that's just loot I found. It is medium, but it is weaker medium, right? Yeah, my halberder armor is just better. Definitely get rid of this light armor. I don't have much use for. I think I'm just gonna get rid of this gabeson. I used it for a little while. It's handy. I think I even built it myself because I thought it was cool. But it's light armor, so even though it has bonus intensity for spellcasting, it's just not the best thing to have as a spellcaster, unfortunately. And hopefully my Griffin set will completely nullify any comparison soon anyway. Let's see, does he have anything cool over here? Like a potion recipe? He has parchment. Tracker's gauntlets, cavalry gauntlets, tracker's boots. Cavalry and tracker set, basically. Ooh. Archer's Gibson. Interesting. Is that medium? It doesn't say what type of armor it is. Item info. That's the wrong button. Item info. Light gear. Don't care. Diagram for glyphs of different... Oh. You can actually get diagrams for making these low-level glyphs. They're pretty shitty glyphs, though, although I assume I might be able to merge these crappy ones into higher-level ones later or something? Conceivably? I'm not sure. Do we have anything that I want to have much reason to grab right now? Does he have silver? I feel like I had use for... Oh, yeah, I think I was able to make... If I could get silver from him... There we go. Oh, he has a whole stack of silver. I'll just grab all that. I'm pretty sure I have use for silver. Not boots. I think I had a better sword I could get. Oh, right. But I need to craft said silver bar. Silver ingot. Where is it? There we go. Craft one of these. Bam. As a result of the loot I got. Although it looks like I might have already had enough silver without getting that. I didn't at the beginning of last episode, but I think I might have just picked some up. What's this? Axemen's gauntlets. Very high armor. Heavy gear. Not interested then. Axemen's trousers. More heavy gear. I'm looking for... Are you not able to make... Are you not able to make weapons here? Are you for real? Oh. Well, that's a problem then. I can at least look into repairing, though, my weapons. It's always a little bit more expensive than I want to. Should I just repair all? Ah, screw it. Repair all. It's entirely possible I'll replace something before I need to repair... Before I genuinely need the repair. But, I'm not the predicting type in this situation, necessarily. It's unfortunate I can't seem to craft what I was looking into. I'll show you guys in a moment.
So long.
Stop talking to me so I can go look at the thing. That rapid-fire text feed of all the things that I looked at. Crafting. Boots, chest armor, crafting, crossbow, gauntlet, junk. There it is. Serpentine steel sword. Silver sword. This had my attention, so I wanted to get another silver to craft it. But I guess I can't craft it here. Only blacksmiths can forge weapons and armors. And only armorers can craft... Oh! I just need to talk to a blacksmith. That's fine. This had my attention because it does slightly less damage than my current sword. But it gives you bonus to ard and bonus to... it gives you a chance to poison. Which is the main thing that got my attention. Is the idea of poisoning enemies seemed like it could be worthwhile. What is this? Silver sword for fighting monsters. Massive damage. Oh, it's level 37. That's why. What's this? A Dorian sword? It's a terrible sword, apparently. Low damage. Yeah, these are all terrible weapons, basically. And then all the stuff that's strong is stuff I can't use, basically. Alright, that's what's wrong here, is I need to talk to the swordsmith. The blacksmith. Oh, the blacksmith might have given me better prices for those weapons, huh? I'm not gonna fret it too hard. Well, they don't seem to have a blacksmith. They just have blacksmithing equipment here. Oh well, let's go talk to the Baron. I'm sure he's in a great mood over the death of his wife.
What the hell happened?
Hanged himself. Plain enough to see.
Was he drunk?
Yeah. Always knew the hooch would be his end.
If I'm to choose between a greater and lesser evil, I'd rather not choose at all. Usually, though, the stakes are just too damn high. Sometimes in choosing a greater evil, you do good, albeit in a small way. When I chose to save the orphans of the swamp, I couldn't know Anna would die. And I never thought the Baron would leave his wife where she lay, find a rope and hang himself. Most times, you make your choice and never look back.
Lost everything he cared for. No surprise he lost the will to live.
Don't look too concerned, you and your boys.
What would you have us do? Sit and wail? Baron was a good soldier, but settling in here at Crow's Perch, it made him soft. We'll introduce a new order. Things will be different now.
I imagine they will.
Wanna hit the Lord, eh? Man. Yeah, you really do just have to pick a choice and just commit to it and just see what the fucking chaos theory result's gonna be. Because there's so many insane steps that can happen. So, as I saved all the children, cool, but I may have unleashed a horrible evil upon the local community, got the woman killed, leading to the Baron killing himself, and leading to a change in command here at Crow's Perch, which could lead to a completely different way of life around here, in maybe a positive or maybe a negative way. I don't know how good of a leader Baron necessarily was, but the sheer number of consequences for that one decision, holy shit. You can't even begin to predict how many levels it's going to have.
Nothing here for you.
Oh, that's not nice. Did I get a reward? I think I got like 100 crowns or something, didn't I? Yeah, I'm up to 1229. That's a boost of some kind. Well, certainly had some negative effects there. Let's get back to the Griffin Hunt gear. Has my inventory doing 61 still? What is taking up so much space? Do you guys have weight? Oh, you guys, each of these crossbow bolts has weight. This thing weighs one. A lot of these things weigh tiny amounts. That's not a big deal. Do these things all weigh something? Alcohol weighs a tiny bit. Oh, all these notes weigh a tiny bit. Oh. All the items in my inventory weigh a little bit. So I'm getting weighed down over time by the sheer number of things I'm keeping around. Even the crafting materials? Oh, yeah. Wow. Hang on a second. This is 0.3 each. Oh, 0.03. That is pretty tiny. But like, this is 0.2. Every 5 of these is worth 1, and I have 20, so I have... This is 4 pounds right here on this one stack. Alkahest weighs a fair amount, so I probably have probably 2 pounds of stuff there. Wow, this stuff does stack up then. That's concerning. Man, does that mean I want to be getting rid of some of this stuff, or is there a storage somewhere I should look into? I don't remember there being a storage in this game necessarily. Let's see. This crystal skull, yeah, everything weighs something. Huh. All right. Well, that's a thing for sure. Let's look into that that Griffin gear like I said we would. All right, we found ourselves back towards down. Oh no. Things have gone poorly here. Okay. Hello. Nice to meet you. Can just put some holes in you real quick. There we go. Holy crap. Alright, I'm at Downwar, and apparently it's overrun by witches now? People used to live here, right? I assume that it got overrun as a result of me unleashing that, that dark spirit, since it's right here by the swamp. I think that's the same town. So I've completely wiped this town out at this point then, haven't I? Hit me a few times, lady. There we go. I have really high silent intensity now, so I can actually withstand a fair amount of damage to keep healing for a little while. There we go. God, that's effective. Now burn! I'm out of range. Shit. My bad. Hey, lady. Witch. Where are you going? Oh, you're a wraith. You could be male. Huh? My mistake. That was sexist of me. There we go. Oh, yeah. Show me your back. Effective, at the very least. Alright, so everyone here is pretty dead. They've had a great time. Wow. Yeah, I really fucked things up, didn't I? Well, at least I can get stuff like that rune. I don't use a lot of those runes on my weapons, but they can, even though I'm a spellcaster, and that's usually what they're good for, just because they're such slight effects, but I can sell the runes for a fair amount of money, I believe. What do we have here? Butcher knife. Oh yeah, that, a lot of dead around here. Empty bottle. This really ended well for no one. No, don't ignite things. Loot stuff, silly. I don't care about igniting things. They just had to make that the same button. How do I look at it? Come on. Just let me loot the box. Come on, really? They desperately need to fix this looting system. Holy shit. It needs to prioritize opening things in the environment, and it needs to I'm not even going to get it. I'm just going to have to leave that loot there because I can't select it as far as I can tell. This is a common complaint about this game, too. It's not just me. Like, you need to be able to have better control over what you're interacting with because your character doesn't do a good job, and you need to be able to do a better job at not freaking prioritizing playing with candles all the time. Furrier looking for work. Furrier and leather worker, 20 years at the table, willing to take on jobs large and small, fixing and creating apparel, fine and rugged, reliable and timely. Will pick up the raw stuffs and deliver the finished wares with a smile. Rat catcher come to town. Rid your hut and yard of mice, rats, and other furry vermin. For a bit extra, I'll see to the crawly, creepy kind as well. Fast and effective, using the latest natural methods. A special magical flute from Hammelstein. That sounds natural. Which do not harm the plants nor friendly beasts. Reasonable prices, effectiveness guaranteed. A wandering rat catcher. Will darn and pitch. If you wear it, I can pitch it, sew it, darn it, or otherwise make it good as new or better. My hands work fast and steady, thread and patches included in the price, but if more than an L's worth of stuff is needed, you'll have to provide it yourself. Payment is eggs, grain, or potatoes preferred. Free dog. Giving me Roger to anyone who will care for him and promise not to eat him. He's a lovely, well-behaved mutt, harks the hand feeds him. But I've not left to feed him with. Perhaps for guarding a yard and garden. Perfect for guarding a yard and garden for herding sheep or pasture. Awfully glad to sleep in a barn. If you can take him, come see Baxter. Wagon for sale. Hay rack wagon for sale. Original owner. Good condition. Hardly used. Keep in barn. Inquire at Medi. We'll trade Sintran rugs for food. I will trade in Nort Sintran rugs 3 for food, meat preferably, though I'll consider greens as well. New items, never used, ideal for decorating walls, lovely fabric with linen warp, meant as a dowry for my daughter, but the Blackens did her in, so there'll be no need for a wedding. Geraldine. Aw. All that little hint of a hustle and bustle here in town, and everyone's very dead. I wonder, I can't remember if I've ever been here before, so I'm not entirely sure if this is the town where the people cut off their ears like a bunch of creepers to satisfy the bog, or if this is somewhere else that I didn't even know about. It's a little hard to keep all of them straight sometimes. Because either I did this, or this place is always messed up. The fact that they're all recent bodies makes me think that this is my mistake, though. That I got everyone killed here. Oh my god. Someone hung themselves. Huh. Maybe this wasn't the beast then. Why would someone be... Well, I don't think the horse would make someone hang themselves. Oh, yeah, that guy's hanging on a wind... Some of these people are dead in a way that makes me think that this place actually fell... I think this place actually fell victim to bandits. People are being hung and stuff like that. Seems like a batch of criminals came through here and wiped everyone out instead. So I may not be responsible for this. Did I already check this house? Oh yeah, this is the one where I can't loot the damn thing in the corner. All these where's this magical universe that video games exist in where all doors are double hinged? Because I want to live in that universe. I'm so sick of trying to figure out if I should push or pull. I can rededicate those mental resources to other more important things, like, I don't know, what episode I left off on an arrow or something. What do we have in here? I will loot everything. I have no regrets. Silver pantaloons! What the hell do you use those for? Oh, awesome, more alcohol for my meditating. Lots of dwarven spirit. Useful in some alchemy recipes. And I believe dwarven spirit can be used just like Alka has to meditate, I think. I could be wrong. Let's look into silver pantaloons. Is that an inventory item? It is not. It's probably a crafting item, isn't it? No? It's an other? It's just something worth money, I assume? Crone's doll. The crones of Velen use these dolls to gain power over people. I still have it around me. Oh, huh. It's worth some money. I'd feel like a terrible person selling it. Maybe I wonder if I should give it to the daughter, or if that's even an option. Silver pantaloons. you can sell it or dismantle it. Ooh. Does it have real silver in it? Because then that could be worth something for me. Anyway, now it's time to set out for that question mark on the map, and then the Witcher gear out in the distance. After dealing with some witches and loot around here, let's get out of town before they come back. Oh, missed that. So did I successfully exercise the area and now it's safe, or is it gonna get like reattacked? I wonder if I'm gonna see more of those little villages that you can like clear out and then people move in, because I believe in White Orchard I randomly encountered one where like, oh yeah, now this place is safe and everyone's moving in. And I don't think that's come up since. This is very high up. It's probably gonna be a monster nest for like harpies or griffins or something, huh? Oh, it's a place of power. Awesome. I like that. I want that. Come on, get on up. Hup, there we go. Careful. Oh yeah, this looks safe.
Medallion's humming. Place of power. It's gotta be.
Another curious. I'm curious. Medium armor, but it's worse. But it has bonus sign intensity for Igni? Oh, how much value do I put on armor? Higher piercing resistance, higher bludgeoning resistance, higher slashing resistance, elemental resistance, higher Igni stat, at the cost of 6 armor overall. Oh, but when I repair it, it'll be only at the cost of 4 armor. Alright, I'll put this new... Aww, but it looks less cool. This is such a cool looking set. I wish I could just make it look like that. Oh well. Do I have an Ig... Let's see. Sock. Put this in a socket of a sword. Put this in gear. Quen intensity. More adrenaline point gain. Oh, sword. I could improve the adrenaline gain of my weapons if I think I'll keep them around. Let's see. Ard intensity. Bleeding. Attack power. And Igni. Okay. Igni sign intensity. Put this in my armor. Now it's up to +6 intensity. Right? That's how it works, I believe. Oh yeah, +6 Igni intensity. Don't want to invest any more than that, because I'll use my other Igni to put into the Griffin gear when I find it, assuming that it has slots, maybe. There's some... this Halberder armor that I'm already not using anymore, it's going to be valuable still, so that's handy. Let's see, I'll use one of my armor repair kits on my equipment to get my armor back. It should be... I think it'll be fully repaired. It's close. Enough so that it has its full armor set. Which... Oh, okay. We learned something here. So the 6 that it's saying is the difference is based on its maximum armor. So it's still... I'm still losing 6 armor when I put this on. But yeah, it needs higher resistance to most damage types. And 6 Igni intensity. That seems worth it to me. Maybe. Anyway, place of power. Which spell's gonna get more powerful? It's Irden. That's sometimes useful, I guess. Alright, so, looking into our character's traits, I think there's something I want to sub in here. So right now we have 5% sign intensity per medium armor. I want that. And something that lets me use adrenaline points to cast. Shit, I really do want to keep those things around. Maybe I have to wait to level up later or something. Something I want to equip when I get the chance, let's see, is... at some point I want to get this, and you get 5% faster adrenaline points, and now your signs... Using signs can generate more, but highest priority is focus, which is adrenaline points now increase both weapon and sign intensity. That'll make my spellcasting more powerful, but I don't think it's going to be worth it quite yet. Oh well. And I don't think I want to unequip any of my current stuff. The closest thing is that, let's see. Yeah, it increases the effectiveness of Axian dialogue, so I do want to keep it equipped, because I can't tell when it's going to come in handy. Oh well. Just gives us another stat point to hold on to for later, which is always handy. Now it's time to look into that Griffin gear. That'll probably be how we wrap up the episode, too, because since we're running a little long already. Whoa! Look at that power slide. Look at that. No, it's not a power slide. That's not what a power slide is, but it looks awesome. Come on, slide. Yeah! Oh, it's a monster den. The Griffin gear has it. This guy died by a grab. Oh God! I didn't expect him to just walk off that ledge. Well, looks like the little spill I took meant that I had to re-loot that entire town from scratch, which was already a bummer. But also, I didn't get that item again. Oh God! When I looted the little thing over here, it didn't give me the same armor piece. So I'm guessing I'm gonna go back to looking like this again. But one upside is that when I was exploring, I found something down here when I was on my way back, because I took a slightly different path. I think it's right here. Ow. Holy crap, you take fast damage. That's insane how fast you take damage when you're falling. Let's see. Can I just meditate till the morning? I guess I'll just use swallows. Wow. That's a bummer. I guess I just didn't realize how much damage you can take because I've never fallen so far. So I need to use the eye, because when I was walking in here originally, the guy was like, "There's an illusion here. Someone placed an illusion here. I have to use the eye." Just in case you forgot about that mechanic from earlier. And that eye is where? I just use it whenever I don't. I don't think I have to equip it, do I? I just hit X.
Something here. Where's that artifact Kira gave me?
It's a good thing I met Kira, huh? Go ahead and light up and head inside. I'm sure this place is safe. Also, we might not make it to the Witcher gear this episode at this rate, if I'm exploring this. Ooh. That looks pretty looty. How dead am I going to be as I approach? Oh, there's a thing upstairs. I think that's on the surface, though. I'm a little spooked. Oh, there's a bad guy. What is that? Is it coming at me? What is that? Elamiara? Oh, you're a creepy little shit. Oh! You're like invisible, kinda. Okay, that's not cool either. Let's try to stun you. Yeah, I don't like you at all. Oh, you're creepy. You're a creepy one. Okay. Why can't I select the shield? What the fuck? Why was it locking me out of my own menu? There we go. Let's give me some hit points back. Hey, asshole. Come here. Oh, you're gross. You're a gross one is what you are. Yeah, you are. Alright, dodged out. Let's go for fire, or probably the axe to stun it. There we go. Hey, buddy. What you up to? You gonna run away? Who's a little nasty? You're a little nasty is what you are. Yep. Get some damage in there real quick. Ow! Oh, shit. That's a problem. Alright. Come on, buddy. Give me those hit points back. I'm in need of hit points. You missed. How did you miss? There we go. Dodge back. Yep. There we go. Be prepped with the Axie this time. Hopefully we'll not take a hit in the meantime this time. Nope. Careful. More Axie. Follow-up attack. Get out of there. I'm trying to be careful about this. Nope, wasn't as careful as I thought I was. Slow down. Dodge out. Oh, unsuccessful, largely. Protective shield. Come on, buddy. Give me my hit points back. I need those to live. Where are you going? Come on. Oh, don't run away. Come on. I just want a party. Ow. Okay, get out. Alright. Axe influence mines. Dodge out. There we go. Things are going okay for us right now. Power attack. Keep our distance. Oh yeah. God, this is really effective. What the heck's an Ikimara? Ekimira Mar whatever. It's a vampire. Oh, hello. Oh, it's gross. Oh, it's a creepy bat creature. Ekimaras. Bah. Ain't nothing to fear, Ekimaras. Why, they ain't nothing more than overgrown bats. Anonymous city guardsman's last words. Like other vampires, Ekimaras are not, despite what village gossips might say, undead humans. They're instead post-conjunction monsters who have no particular feelings about garlic, holy water, or religious symbols. Go figure. Unlike their portrayals in ballads and legends, they look nothing like handsome, pale aristocrats with charming Eastern accents. Though, like catacuns or neocrets, they do bear a strong resemblance to overgrown bats. They do not suck blood from the neck of virgins with a delicate kiss-like bite. They tear them into shreds using long, sharp claws and then slurp the splattered blood off the ground. Okay. So they're pleasant. They're the pleasant kind is what we're getting here. Hey, level 11. More points for me. I already know, though, that I won't get level... Oh, there's some vampire stuff. I already know that I'm not going to get, I'm not going to be able to get a new ability point, because the next slot unlocks at level 12, so I'm just going to not look right now. But we might as well loot the area. Probably going to wrap up the episode here. Witcher George's journal. I think I accidentally... Oh, that's the Griffin armor. Oh. Wow, here I thought I got sidetracked and I wasn't going to make it to my goal. And this is the exact stuff I was here for. Griffin boots, gauntlets, trousers, armor. I was thinking I was going to have to wait till next episode for this. I just happened to be going I happened to go exactly where I needed to go. Didn't really mean to do that. Just try to creep past this stuff to keep looting someone's grave. Bison grass, ballads and hymns. No, I'm trying to loot. Excuse me, I'm trying to grave rob here. If you could just cooperate with me. The slaughter of Sintra. Oh. These sound like pleasant things to read to the audience later. Not now, because the episode's so long at this point. I'll probably read George's journal to wrap things up. There we go, Nifgardian Lebon. These are all handy things. More mushrooms for me. I'll take them. What else can we find around here? This is just the creepiest enemy. He died in such an awkward, propped-up position. Alright, cool monster design. With some of these designs, Witcher is right up there with From... I said Witcher. CD Projekt RED seems to be right up there with From Software, with their ability to craft some really cool monster designs. What was this used for? Is it telling me to use Igni? No, it's saying to use Ard. Bloom! Dare I investigate deeper? Oh, cool. So happy things are happening down there. Where is... Ballads and Hymns, Slaughter of Sintra. Ah, now that it's going to show up as being red already, huh? I don't really mean to do that. There we go. Witcher George's Journal. Read for additional information. Having heard rumors of a dragon, I raced at full speed to Velen. Sadly, I was dragged away from my hunt by the prefects of Gors Velen. They summoned me as an expert to solve the riddle of a string of shipwrecks suspected to be the work of night wraiths. Huh. Seems a dragon ravaging the countryside is a lower priority than block trade routes. Luckily, I was able to solve the riddle of the lone lighthouse quickly and raced off after the dragon. I learned that the peasants from the ravaged villages had taken shelter in the elven catacombs under Lake Vindemir. Wise. Yet they were not wise enough to bring firewood, and so warmed themselves by burning elven manuscripts. It aches my heart to think what knowledge about the elder folk went up in those flames. At least a few of the manuscripts survived, including some highly interesting sketches of armor. Yet, enough about that. Eyewitnesses have reported ashen scales, height of haunches, 2 fathoms, length, 5 fathoms, addendum, estimated weight approximate 14 quintals, able to maintain a high temperature in its bellows, dragon lungs, for longer than a quarter hour. Conclusion, we are dealing with a green dragon. Commencing hunt. So Witcher George was on the hunt for a dragon when he died, apparently. Interesting. What does it say? We only have 4 out of 6 of the diagrams. Search the ruins of the fortress by the lighthouse and search the Lord's castle. So we have new locations to check now. That's good to know. Go ahead and pop my shield as I fight these wraiths, because the wraiths have a tendency to get hits in. But they're relatively straightforward fights, so if you just have a little bit of armor to keep you safe for a moment, you can usually take them out pretty quickly. There we go. Where you at, buddy? I see you running out there. I'm taking you out, because I'm not letting you sneak up behind me later. Yeah. Alright. You think you're sneaky? I'll show you sneaky. Okay, here he comes. Okay, that was rude. Do not appreciate your behavior. More Spectre stuff. Alright. I want to get better saddlebags just to carry all my crafting gear, because I don't want to throw any of it away. Oh god. Okay. Just gonna put another shield on then, if that's what you're gonna do, is place mines everywhere. More shield. Oh, it's exploding mist, my bad. Okay, I made a mistake then. Can I just hold up a shield though and just regen, absorb the damage to heal? Cause that's cool. Hey Wraith. There we go. Yeah, that totally worked. I recovered hit points. Ow, now I'm on fire and everything sucks. Holy crap. Oh my god, I'm an idiot. I'm so sorry, everyone. Put the torch away, dummy. Put it away. How do I make you put it away? There we go. Jesus Christ, this game sometimes. Sometimes the Witcher just does not want to listen to anything you're trying to tell him to do. And he's just standing there like a jackass, just dying. I'm like, you son of a bitch. Alright, so, bad. Bad poison's happening. Ah, fuck. I mean, that was my fault. I wasn't ready for it. I wasn't expecting all the poison to come back that fast. Alright, I need to get in the better habit of manually saving more often, because they made me go all the way back to place where you guys saw me save last at the place of power, so I had to redo the whole fight and everything. Went smoother this time. I just used a thing to make me generate stamina faster. Alright, this time I'll be smart enough to not walk in there with a torch. Forgot about the... To be fair, I didn't see the, I didn't actually see all of the, smoke at first, but yeah, the, having the torch out was causing everything to explode. Nope, dodge. Where's it going? The struggle between picking between your fire spell and your... Oh! And your anti... The fire smell for smoke versus the Irden spell for getting rid of these wraiths. Hello, wraith. I mean, the wraith's temporary, at least. The smoke might keep coming back, but the wraiths can only come back so many times. Where is he? Deal with him. Come on. Alright, now get out of the poison. I'm definitely running into problems with the casting in this game, where I was fighting the vampire again, and yeah, like, I was trying to cast the spell to mess with his mind, and it kept freezing up. I'm like, you can't do that in combat! I'm like, what are you talking about? I'm like, I have a full stamina meter, let me cast the spell, and I'm like, nope, it's just gonna stand there, and then he hits me in the face, and I'm like, god damn it, now I have to figure out how to recover these hit points. The game made me lose, because it was just... The controls are probably the worst part of this game. Everything from moving around to picking up items to riding a horse to certain parts of combat just not working properly sometimes. Hopefully they'll update it and improve everything, which I have faith that they might, because they're famous for putting out Witcher 1 and 2 enhanced editions, which they just did extensive patching of both games for free, which is really cool. So they care about their products a lot and will continue to improve them, I'm sure. Ow. Wow, he was in slow-mo zone and I was behind him and he managed to get the hit in anyway. Alright. A little bit of mushroom for me. A few more crafting items. I should switch to my protective shield so I can recover hit points when I fight next. And is there a monster den down here? So yeah, I said I was going to end the episode when I finished the Griffin school thing, but I should focus on this for now, because if I don't, I'm at risk of forgetting about this whole place. So I'm just gonna... This episode's just gonna be as long as it takes to do this. Ow. Jesus. Cast! There we go. That was a good example right there. I was just sitting there pressing the button to cast the spell and nothing was happening. I'm like, god damn it. Like, my meter's full. Why can't I cast? I'm just trying to cast. Alright. Yep. Oh, god damn it. They're still hitting me. You guys hit hard. Take some hits. Dodge. Take this wraith out. There we go. Now there's just one, so it'll be easier. Prime real estate for getting some hit points back. Come on. There we go. Oh, I missed. Damn it. Attacked in the wrong direction that time. Let's see. Where are the remains for me? Oh, this body has stuff on it. One florin. And the game had the gall to call them florins. Alright. A little bit of mushroom on the way. Oh, there's a lot of mushrooms in here. More mushrooms I don't even necessarily know I have a use for currently, but I'll grab them. Dragon Slayer's Grotto. What? What am I getting involved in? Where am I coming out? Is this where I fell from? This might be where I fell from the, oh yeah, that wall up there is probably where I was sliding down the mountainside and fell off. Where's Dragon Slayer's Grotto? Oh, we have a new teleporting spot. Okay. Underneath this fortress lies a musty rank cave in which a lost traveler will find nothing but fattened leeches. If he's lucky, nevertheless, the village elders insist on repeating legend that gave the grotto its name, of a legendary dragon slayer said to be buried somewhere deep inside. Well, that was the first thing I found. Alright, so I can just leave at this point in this direction. Was there another direction to explore, though? There might not be... I think I came in... What is happening in here? Is that just a wraith? Set up that magic trap. Ow, dick. Ow, dick. Come on, come hit me now. Come on, come on. I'm ready for it. Come at me. Now in the face. There we go. Got some hit points back. That was a really loud roar coming from a wraith. I thought I was walking in on the dragon they were talking about. A little bit more loot. How much bigger is this area? I was thinking it'd just be a few rooms really quick. Oh my god. Those crafting items. Oh, new surprise combat. Shit. I wasn't ready for combat. I thought we were good. Hey, friend. There we go. Give me hit points. There we go. Thanks for the hit points. Oh, here it comes. Oh, he got me. Damn it. He took all the hit points back. You son of a bitch. I wanted those. Keep an eye on my stamina meter for when it falls out. And finish him. There we go. More or less kept my health back off. This is turning into an extended loot episode, isn't it? Alright. What else was here? Wolf hide, white bear hide. Hearing noises. What else? Is it safe to go in here? Maybe I aggroed him from outside at this point. These seem like really worthwhile pieces of loot. Crystallized essence. Ooh. Equipment for repairing. Wow, lots of currency. Definitely want to get to... Is it Novigrad, I believe? Novigrad? That I need to go to this. Yeah, there's a bank in Novigrad, which I need to investigate for getting this all these currencies switched out. White Wolf, ooh, Diagram Thor Hairn, and White Refard's Decoction. Those could be really cool items. Alright, at this point, I feel confident in leaving this area, I think. I think we've explored the places where the extra loot can be found. It's a good thing I took a look, too. Alright, so we have an ungodly amount of new stuff this episode. Alright, I need to look at crafting if I want to find out what Thor Hairn is. I would assume it's a new weapon, because that's just the type of name you give to, like, a sword, right? Crossbow bolts, gauntlets, junk, silver sword. Yeah, Thorhanna. Level 23, very high damage. 50% critical damage bonus. Goddamn. I actually have the materials required to make it? Wow. You just need 2 silver, some leather scraps, which is easy to come by, and monster blood, and then you have that. But it requires you to be level 23, and a journeyman blacksmith needs to be found. Wow. Those are surprisingly low requirements for such a high value sword. Unfortunately, I won't be able to use it for another 12 levels, dear lord. The scaling at which you find new equipment is all over the place in this game. Alright, so let's take a look at the Griffin set. Required level 8. Oh, I can basically craft this. I just need leather scraps, and then I'm set. And I could probably get a bunch of leather scraps by scavenging all of my equipment. It has 8 more armor, 5% psion intensity, making it great for casting. Resistance to monster damage, 7%. Resistance to elemental, 17%. It doesn't really offer piercing and slashing armor, though. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I want to look into crafting this, then. This is just the trousers, to be specific, but all I need is leather scraps. Other pieces might be harder to craft, especially if they require the same things. Griffin gauntlets. Also need leather scraps for this. And I need powdered monster tissue for this one, so I won't be able to craft this one right away unless I... Oh! Actually, I might be able to turn something into that griffin armor. I need monster eye. Okay, we'll see if I can turn something into that. And I need a shirt. Just any shirt? I don't have a shirt? Oh, I probably sold the shirt, because I was like, this is too much shit to carry around. Alright, we'll see what I can craft. There's also boots, right? Trousers. Does the set not have boots to it? I looked at the gauntlets already, right? Yeah, it's the powdered stuff. Oh, boots is on top. Griffin boots, I have everything except for leather scraps. Alright, I'm gonna go to town, make a bunch of leather scraps, see how much of the set I can craft. And we'll jump cut to me having the materials, hopefully. Or I'll show you the process of me getting materials, and then that'll be the end of the episode, which is probably really long, but... Alright, Griffin school happened. Fast travel. Alright, this sheepskin will give me some leather scraps. Go ahead and dismantle that. Oh yeah, that's a whole bunch of leather scraps. Like I suspected, the silver pantaloons can give me silver, just like I was hoping it would. Probably want to get a decent number of silver, because, yeah, we have uses for silver. Pure silver will give... Oh. Each pure silver will give me one ingot. Maybe I should grab that? I might be able to turn it into something else, though. Although I totally forgot about it earlier. Alright, I have a bunch of necker eyes. I don't know what necker eyes are useful for, so I'll turn half of them into just normal monster eyes to give me more materials for that. Alright, I now have the materials to make the griffin trousers for 8 more armor. This is the same stats. This is the one I went into detail over. It'll cost me 50. Let's go for it. Bam! Witcher gear. You picked up your first item in a set of elite Witcher gear. Such items can be upgraded by taking them to a craftsman and providing an appropriate diagram. So hang on to them, even if you find something better. Good to know. All right. So we're done with the trousers. Can I make the gauntlets? The gauntlets require powdered monster tissue. All right. It looks like these griffin feathers can be turned into a powdered monster tissue. Was that enough, I hope? I wish that it didn't open everything every single time. It takes so long to it's preferable to have everything closed. There we go. So these gauntlets will also get me 8 more armor. Significant boost there. Bam! Gauntlets out of the way. Now all that's left is boots, which I also have enough for. Yeah, we're all set to make griffin boots. Now I have everything set except for the armor. The armor requires... Oh, I have all the materials for the armor too. I just need a shirt. Where am I going to get a shirt? So I'm here in the Red Baron's Keep, mainly because I was trying to find a shirt to steal somewhere around here so I can make the armor. And I found a note from him, which I haven't read yet. It's somewhere around here. What's that bag? Oh, that's an armor kit, isn't it? Yeah, I've been looting the shit out of this place since the owner's dead. Let's see. The Baron's notes. Oriton boat builder went all in and got arse plowed by Lady Luck. Send men to collect. If you don't have the coin, take his cards. Never play with that crazy old bugger from Brackenheim again. Maybe he really can see the future. Surely saw through my every ruse. Oh. I thought it might have been a suicide note, frankly. But anyway, with the notes, I found a card left behind by him. You remember that the Baron was the leader of a tournament group, so, like a Gwent club, which I obviously can't take part in now with him being dead, unfortunately. Let's see. I'm trying to find the card that he left behind. So this is Sokatil. There it is. That's Sigismund Distra. Anyway, it's a, oh yeah, level 4 spy, usable in the Northern Realms deck. Or is it everybody? Yeah, he's Northern Realms. Alright, so that's a spy I can add to my primary deck. I actually have one to add. Awesome. So that's what was left behind after he died. The note says, Gwent's like politics, just more honest. Alright, so we got a little note about playing Gwent, and we got the card, which I think someone may mention in the comments I would get if I would have gotten from Baron. I was planning on playing against him, but now he's dead, so that won't be happening in this playthrough. Let's take a look at the secondary quests. Let's see. Does the Gwent Club even exist anymore? Playing Innkeepers. Velen players. Oh, there it goes. Yeah, Gwent Velen players. Though you might think it unlikely, even war-ravaged Velen boasted many prominent Gwent players. They possessed certain valuable cards, which Geralt wished to add to his collection. To do that, he needed to defeat them. The first on his to-fleece list, the Bloody Baron. Welp! I guess I failed this forever. Look for a unique card and information about players in the Baron's office. So I assume that I lost access to the unique card from... I could have gotten this unique card by beating him, but failed it. But then I think I got the additional objective of doing the same thing just by finding it on his counter. So hopefully now that I've read that note, maybe those new people are going to show up. Usually I have to leave the menu. Is it going to say quest updated? Not necessarily. All right. Well, hopefully that little note will give me information about how to find more players, and that'll be where we find more Gwent. I still need to find a shirt. Oh, I think I missed it because it's all the way down here, but right here there's a shirt way down at the bottom of that guy's inventory. Also, really fucking expensive, but I'm just committed at this point. I want to get this stuff crafted. So, we'll go ahead and... Let's see, chest armor, Griffin armor... Alright, that's all I needed was the shirt, so now I can make my Griffin armor. And just like that, I'll have my full set.
Wouldn't mind a
God damn it. All these moments where I accidentally click dialogue options leaving. Whoops. Alright, so we'll put on our new armor. What's it look like? Ptoom. Yeah, not as cool as the Halberdier's armor, but it's also noticeably stronger. Noteworthy, 5% sign intensity, 5% sign intensity, 5% sign intensity, and 5% sign intensity for each of these. It doesn't say that on everything, right? Yep, that's actually specific to this equipment. So I just got 20% sign intensity just from these four pieces, plus an additional 20% because they're medium, and I have that perk that gives me 5% per item, so they're each worth 10%, basically. And then, let's see, I also have 40% sign intensity on the left, 10 on the right. So I have an overall sign intensity bonus of 92%, which is pretty big deal. So we're definitely getting properly decked out to be a powerful spellcaster. All right, thanks for watching, guys, like always. I'll see you next time.